Hey, this is Ben with Ben's Carts and LearnHotDogs.com, and I've got some awesome stuff for you today. I'm sitting here in my kitchen. This is a 1970s kitchen. This was built in 1970, so 46 years old. And we haven't updated it a bit, except the bourbon. That's new. And I am going to show you the foot-long hot dog, but with a twist, like a Spanish-Mexican twist. It's going to be awesome. You're going to love it. Stay tuned. And if you're wondering about the shirt, this is compliments of my buddy, Jason Brown. Love food truck company. Love hot dog company. Lemonade Brothers and Conspiracy Food Trucks, which is a conspiracy. I'll see you in just a minute. Now, I want you to know you can do this in your steam pan. You don't have to use one of these handy-dandy whatever staub pans. Just normal boiling pan on your hot dog cart or a food concession trailer, whatever, and boil some water. If you will boil the dogs first, just a little bit, you will be able to grill them quicker, because tonight I'm grilling dogs. Now, you don't have to grill the dogs to make this meal. It actually comes out dang good without grilling it. I just like the look, and a lot of people do. And my wife's got some chili because she cannot eat a hot dog without chili. So she's got chili going, but I'm going to boil these dogs here in just a second, and I'll show you more in just a minute or two. All right, here's my footlongs. I'm not showing the brand because I don't have a favorite brand in footlongs, and there's less selection on footlongs, so no brand. And then my water's boiling, and I'm going to toss these in. Let me just give you a little tip. If you're doing catering or something, if you boil dogs, pre-boil them, and then turn them off so they don't split, because you don't want them to split, all you're doing is pre-cooking them. You're getting them to temp. Then when you grill, it's real quick. All you're doing is getting the lines and the caramelization of the sugars and fats on the outside of the skin. It's just a no-brainer way to produce the best hot dog flavor. So that's what I'm doing here tonight. Now, if you notice these right here, little hint. If you pay attention to your emails, if you're subscribed to LearnHotDogs.com blog, there's going to be an announcement. Or you can, on our Facebook page at facebook.com/Ben's Carts, you'll be able to get these free. And we're going to be announcing that or releasing that very, very soon. So all I'm going to do is take these out, and there's more to this. But I'm going to take these out. It's a big foot-long hot dog, and I'm going to boil it for a minute. And if you see here, I've got about 6 hot dogs we're going to be boiling. It will cool off your water. So that's where we are. I will boil these. Now, it's different in a steam pan. It doesn't take long. You know, boiling from frozen, these aren't even frozen. So maybe a minute and a half to 2 minutes, okay? And you can try this out at home without wasting dogs or worrying about ruining anything. You can do this quick, but that's where we are. My wife's chili probably needs stirring a little bit. And, yep, looking good. And come back for the bottles, all right? I'll be back with you just shortly. All right, let me show you this real quick. This is cheddar cheese, sour cream, and lettuce. And you're going, well, I can't have that on my cart. Well, it is harder to do sour cream on your cart, and some states don't allow it, but you can do it in catering. And let me just tell you something. There's squeeze tubes for sour cream. Daisy makes one, and there's actually like guns for it, like a caulk gun looking thing. In fact, we're giving away one very soon, so stay tuned to our Facebook page on that. But the dogs are done. As far as boiling, I'm not done with them because I'm going to show you something here in just a second, but I wanted you to see the lettuce. And now you could have jalapenos here. You could have like cayenne pepper. You can do about anything you want here, but I wanted you to see this part, and then I'll come back in just a second. Now we are outside, and I want to show you. I've brought some dogs out, and I've got my grill going. Now you don't have to have blue lights on your grill, okay? You don't. But you can have a normal grill on a hot dog cart, and that'll work just fine. But I'm going to show you this in a minute. Now, what I've done is I've got regular hot dogs that are ready to go, okay, full size. Then these are footlongs. But then I've split some, because this is the secret. This is how to make extra money. That one's got a little cheese extra on it from where I cut up everything. So bottom line is you're going to see something cool, how to actually save money and make more money as you serve with this cool Mexican treat. So get ready for this. All right, you can see how they've plumped up, and some have even split. Now, you don't have to leave them this long. I've moved it over a little bit, but those are really done. They're done when you boil them. They're done when you get them out of the package. But you get the grill marks. You get the caramelization. I'm going to show you up real close. That's about a foot long, at least 10 inches, right? All right, so here we go. Hey, folks, we're almost done. What I've done is I've grilled this, okay? That's a half of a hot dog, but it's a half of a foot long. So it's a lot of meat. Now, if you come over here, you'll look that I have a tortilla. Now, you could use the smaller tortilla and the smaller dog. I used a foot long, so I'm using the bigger tortilla. And all you would do from here is add a little cheese. I like to put my cheese on first so that I get a little melt with it, with that hot dog. Then a little bit of lettuce, okay? Then you want to add a little bit of sour cream. I think the commercial goes, a dollop of daisy will do you. Now, if you have the squirter, which we're going to be giving away soon, you won't have to worry about using a spoon. But I'm at home tonight, and this just makes better sense. So what I'll do is take this. Then I've still got maters. I didn't even tell you about the maters. So I'm going to dump on some maters. Then we will wrap this up, and I'm going to show you a trick on wrapping this. Okay? Take it this way, fold up the bottom, then wrap this way. Okay? Just fold it up. You'll get a little sour cream. Then you put it in your wax paper. Now you have a complete hot dog, burrito, or taco. That's it. Now you can serve these on taco shells. You can serve them like this. You can add cayenne pepper. You can do whatever you want. But that, you can't tell me that that isn't freaking awesome. The beauty of this all is you get to save money because you split your dog. You get to serve something freaking awesome, okay? Something unique that no one's doing. Do it at your catering events. If your state allows you, health department allows you to do it on your cart. Either way, you've got something cheaper, easier to store than buns. Splitting dogs is the bomb, and they get a good meal, the good value. They'll be happy. I think you'll love it, and I know your customers will love it because my kids, my family, my friends love this. I hope you enjoy it.